Ecuador, a land born of fire. A place where children can enjoy candies and play the basketballs without being called for traveling, evidently. What are these questions? What is the answer? Will Shano's quest prove to be a success?
Anybody have a newspaper? Something?
Of course it will.
Welcome to the Galapagos Islands. The natives call it the Galapagos Islands.
For this voyage, we first embark for a wet landing on Bacha's Beach, where we are greeted by many, many of what scientists now call crabs, which you will also be greeted by if you ever make a wet landing on my ex-girlfriend. And now I've just been told that our tour guide has told Shano some information about this particular iguana, so now he would like to go on camera and speak as if he thought of it himself. The dominant religion of the marine iguana is Mormon. This explains why they never drink alcohol or caffeine. They each display different colors that represent the island from which they are from. Unless you are colorblind or you can only see things in like green or something. It is accepted that the land iguana is much more attractive than the marine iguana. But in recent past, a marine iguana must have been able to score with one because we now have what's called a hybrid iguana. This is not only an evident example of evolution, but it proves that ugly people can get laid as well. Ah, you are in luck, my friends. What you are looking at is the elusive yellow-crowned night heron. It has been suggested that these birds actually sneak into large groups of iguanas, demonstrating a dominant behavior that clears the entire group from the area, a behavior that has never been caught on video. Could this be what scientists have been waiting to witness for over 100 years? Perhaps no. That bird should be ashamed of himself. Galapagos is where the cold Humboldt Current from the Antarctica and the warm Panama Current and the occasional El Nino Current cross. Such currents not only bring life, but affect the weather above and below the water. This explains the cold water you can find here on the equator. And the cold water may also explain why so many fishes have such small penises.
I probably smell a little bit worse than this guy does right now. Just a fun animal fact.
The fun animal fact is not that the young sea lion smells good, but that Shano smells horrific. Notice how when Shano finally leaves the ledge, the male sea lion can finally stand to be there. And this does not say much for Shano because all of the other sea lions actually refer to this old bull as Stinky Nuts. Here is a question. What is the difference between a sea lion and a seal? To many, this is harder than telling Asians apart. Now it is true that the pup may still have to learn the habitat that it is most comfortable in. But with the evolution of television, sea lion pups have become even cuter in fast motion. Look how itchy he is. That is precious. These albatrosses mate for life, so the male always returns to the previous year's breeding ground and waits for his partner. They have a single chick, which usually turns out to be as ugly as this one. Eventually, the chicks are left alone so that both parents can look for food, which is necessary because that is an awkwardly large baby to feed. This silly-looking male is putting out the vibe that he is now ready for the sex. When he finds the right female, they will engage in a very noisy and complex courtship ritual, and this extraordinary dance is greatly enhanced when they listen to Stevie Ray Vaughan. Albatrosses love the blues. Let's see what Shano has found on Española Island.
Now this island has one main attraction that keeps the tourists coming back for more, and that's boobies. Lots and lots of boobies.
Blue-footed boobies. That's a nice play on words, Shano. You are hilarious. Notice how the male carefully chooses each piece of the nest and clears it with the female before using it. The males more often find themselves doing this after a late night of drinking. Or maybe this male is just, how you say, whoops, booby wit. You know what I mean? yes, that was a joke on purpose. When courting, the male forces air into the gular sac, inflating it like a red balloon for maybe over 20 minutes. The bigger and brighter the sac, the more attractive the male. And if I only had a peso for every time I heard that one, I would have like 7 pesos.
We're gonna get serious for just a minute here so you can enjoy the underwater life of the Galapagos.
Great blue ocean under me, take me far away to the land of safety, up over the silver waves.
Start wearing purple, wearing purple. Start wearing purple for me now.
You ready for some naughty diving?
All your sanity and wits, they will all vanish, I promise. It's just a matter of time.
Okay, now that I am finished throwing up in my mouth, we let Shano salvage some of his dignity as he continues our tour.
A little trick you can do with these lava caves is if you turn the lights out and you be completely silent, one, you'll experience complete and total darkness, and two, you can actually hear the cave living with all the animals and the lava flowing. So we're gonna do a trick. I want you to turn your TV way up, and I'm going to turn the lights out, and you can hear what I'm talking about. All right, here we go.
And so much for Shano's dignity. They are nomadic by nature. Observe while this one gears up for a long and arduous journey. He gathers his strength, takes a deep breath, and he is on his way. And he is spent. Exploring this land for yourself will no doubtedly awaken your curiosity of nature and perhaps of life in general. Or perhaps you don't like animals. So maybe you should stay home.
I'm Shano with the Vano and the Braino.
And I am your voiceover, Paco with the taco in his saco. Adios, my friends. Thank you so much for enjoying with us.